In the Orient, peace is both how you would say hello and how you would say goodbye. It's what you would say when you would meet, but it's also what you would say when you would part. So people would say salam, salam, or shalom, shalom, which means good morning or good night, hello or goodbye. In the same way, I believe peace is both our good morning and our good night. When we walk in the absolute hopes atmosphere in which we live, move, and have our being, I believe peace is both our good morning and our good night. It's our birthright and our death certificate. It is our beginning and it's our ending. It's the alpha and it's also the Z, the Zay. It's the omega. In the same way, I believe, and I was reading this in an illustration, pictorial analogy written by an author a long time ago today. He was talking about how like a placid lake hidden in the hills, I love this, like a placid lake hidden in the hills, reflecting both sunshine and shadow, peace is the result of equilibrium, the poise of antagonistic elements and forces held in check by one another. So it is ultimate balance. It's salam, salam, good morning, good night, birthright, death certificate. It's the alpha, omega, beginning, the end. In fact, the Greek word for cosmos is cosmos. The Greek word for world is cosmos with a K, cosmos, and it literally means a well-ordered system. So we have this cosmic, well-ordered, copacetic reality in which we move. And so that's why we can walk in peace, because we walk in the absolute hope's philosophy. That is the philosophy of absolute hope. And this is very, very important. So the Greek word for world is cosmos, and it means the universe, world, the affairs, or the inhabitants of the world, but it can also mean a copacetic, well-ordered system. And I believe that the antagonistic forces, when held against, holding each other in balance, are actually creating and resulting in an occasioning an equilibrium, which causes us to walk with peace, because like that's how we evolved as creatures, right? As a species, we have, you know, irises around our pupils so people can see where we're looking, because evidently if you didn't, you died off, right? Like you were killed off or you weren't able to mate. And so that part just died off. So we evolved in such a way that people could see what we're looking at, what we're focusing on. And I really do believe that what we're focusing on dictates and determines our reality. Just like you can see the colors in my eyes, so you know what I'm looking at. You can see what I'm up to. Even my cat, like when we look at each other, he wants to see what I'm up to. He can see it in the colors of my eyes and my pupils. In the same way, that contrast and juxtaposition, I believe we can have a copacetic, well-ordered system when our focus is the absolute hope. Then of course, like antagonistic forces balancing each other out that result in an occasion equilibrium, so too we're going to be like that placid lake reflecting both sunshine and shadow, saying salam, salam, shalom, shalom. It's our greeting, it's our parting, it's our good morning, it's our good night, it's our birthright, it's our death certificate, it's our beginning and our end.